morning with our little face-to-face check-in with Faye. As you can see, she's looking sick. 6 weeks out from the first timer show, which if you watched last week's video, we went through some stuff with her, some posing and whatnot. So every Saturday we have a little, well, we have our check-in day, which is done via our website and whatnot, where we have all, you know, we get all our information and whatnot. But then obviously as Faye trains with us, trains in our gym, sorry, Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon, once we finish check-ins, we like to get in here, have a little look, go through some posing, just make sure everything's on point. So as you can see, 6 weeks in, sorry, 6 weeks out. Was it last week when we filmed, the week before? So 2 weeks since she was on the channel, wasn't it?
Was it 2 weeks?
Because it wasn't last week.
Yeah, the video went up this week, was 2 weeks
ago. As you can see, the progress she's made in 2 weeks, it's crazy. Still got 6 weeks to go. She's off to train in a minute. But yeah, starting off the day, little bit of motivation from Faye, looking six weeks out. We're going to be keeping sort of track and documenting her road to the stage, as I know a lot of our followers have been following her journey just through our challenges and into contest prep. So we're looking forward to showcasing that to you guys. But yeah, man, so have a little look, take it all in, get some motivation. 6 weeks time, gonna smash this first time and show.
All right, guys, what is going on? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is we've switched it up a little bit. So the last few Saturdays we've been working on some RDLs, working on that posterior chain alongside with some top up work as well. So RDLs, hamstring work, and then possibly some arms, which we've done last week. So just a little top up to keep you guys updated. We're currently 5 weeks out. If everyone has been following the channel, following the series, is we've completely switched things up. Just because of how things are going at the moment, business wise and everything, I wanted to bring the show earlier. I wanted to get a nice early show done, in and out the way, hopefully qualify in a two bro show, and then do a British final towards the end of the year. For everyone who doesn't know, obviously I'm having a baby as well, so that kind of threw in the mix, made things a little bit difficult, so I had to prioritize certain things and make sure that we get the show done. I'm gonna be a sick dad, and then we fucking win the British final. Let's get it.
Oh my god, what happened, man? All of a sudden, you just like evolved.
Yeah, you're blocking his abs, man.
Sorry, bro. Is that you evolved?
Theo, I'm not even gassing you, but you look fresh today.
I look fresh.
Yeah, man.
Super fresh. Call me Super from now on.
Right, guys, so first movement that we're basing the workout on today is RDLs with our deadlifts. As you guys know, if you don't, we've always incorporated some form of deadlift into our routine. In my opinion, one of the best back builders, one of the best things for your posterior chain, like it's a must. But obviously with good form, nice and safe. So we've switched to RDLs for a little bit. Hamstrings are one of our weak points. And what we like to do with our squat variations, with our deadlift variations, and our press variations, is sort of rotate those every, anywhere from 4 to 8 weeks. So when we start seeing progress slow down, or we start feeling beat up from a certain movement, we switch it up a little bit. So we have made the switch to RDLs from regular deadlifts to RDLs for the next few weeks. Like I said, to really focus on the posterior chain, hammies, glutes, lower back, and just general back fitness as well. Like I said, it's one of the best things you can do. So same sort of process in terms of rep ranges and working sets. We do 2 heavy work sets, a 6 to 8 rep set, 12 to 15 rep set. Our aim is to progress on those each and every week. So this is only our second week doing it, so we're still sort of finding our feet with things. But it's what we like to do on a Saturday, and it's a weak point, hamstrings and whatnot. And like Troy mentioned, we might do a little bit of a top up on arms after. But today is mainly hamstrings, posterior chain, starting with the RDLs first exercise.
That one really nice. Concentration gone, lads.
Hold on. I'm fucking getting back, thank you, little prick.
I thought that worked. Nah, I put myself off, man. I lost, come out of the zone, didn't I? Full of air. I'll go back in, I'll go back in. Shit!
Let's hope it doesn't happen again. Again, man. Just putting myself. Keep fighting, bro. Fuck. Let me come back, man.
Is it smelling or what?
I'm not smelling. Just put it in.
Just them airy ones. That's what happens. But this is, as you said, it's in the other video. This is why you gotta get all your gas and your poo and whatever's in there out beforehand.
I'm empty.
Get it out of the way,
bro. I'm empty, bro.
Yeah. That's how you know no one's really trained hard enough, because no one shits themselves anymore.
And they hear no one farting either. You don't hear no one farting.
You're acting too stush, bro. Can't shit yourself and show me your reps, man.
Don't wear your boy pants on like that. No bother.
There we go. That's it, Charlie. Yeah, shoulder. Yeah, perfect. Good, and again. Keep that body, bro. Let's go. Four, nice. Yep, come on, work is there. Take it in. Every five, and again. Yep, yeah, perfect. Good, and again, let's go. Two more. Keep them tight. Here we go. Yep. Yeah, good. Last one then. Last one, bro. There's more. We'll take it, bro. Let's go. Come on,
fight,
good, and again.
Oh, come on. Oh,
yeah, more there.
Yeah. Chest
out
tightly.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. Good set, good set.
I say this to all my clients all the time. Sometimes we just have days where weights aren't moving like you like them. I feel good, but going through that, especially deadlift as well, I'm a good deadlifter, a good squatter, so I know when I'm on, if that makes sense. They're not feeling too good, but I did 5 plates last week for my working set, so I don't really want to drop below that, so I'm going to give it a go, see what we get.
Do 7 plates and if you're fucking back?
One day. You know why it is? It's because I haven't got my belt. Yeah, I've had to use Troy's, but I haven't got my trusty belt. Shout out to Mo, because he stole my belt. Hinchington.
Choice is good. Choice is as good. Look.
That's what's wrong with Choice. That is the problem.
You're
too thick. Thicker than a snicker.
One hand! Yes! Everyone like that. Good. Ah. One! Two! Yes! More! Get stronger, Lou. Get stronger now. Fuck this. Come on! Show me.
Yep.
Oh. Yeah.
Good.
Fucking work.
Here we go then.
Again. Who's everyone wrong? Come on. Fuck this.
Go. Yeah. Fight. Yeah. Come on. Yeah.
Easy.
There's another one there. There was another one.
I'm happy that considering that was the same as last week. But my aim was just to keep the quality of the reps. They definitely weren't moving like I would like to. But that's what I'm on about. You can't always progress every week. It's not possible. So if the my goal was to try and maintain or keep a high quality of execution, so I'm still getting the work out of it. Oh, my boots on fire.
Oh, that's all done.
Is my dad's old one, man.
Where's my waist trainer in it? Where did it come, son? Good, back, bad back in it. I'm training that, dad.
Walking around the house like that, with some big up top, we're all tight in the middle.
This guy, dad's feeling good. Yeah, my dad's like, my whole bodybuilding trousers, I bought my dad a couple pairs of them, so he rocks them. Your dad moved away, show that.
My dad plays the guitar in it.
Yeah,
it's game over then. My dad thinks he's fucking. Well, I don't even know someone called with a guitar. I think he's bad.
I bought a guitar?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my dad plays the bass.
Bertie on the drums.
Look out for our dad's band coming real soon. Yeah, but I don't need that speed. I don't need that power. I'm a simple man. I want a car that looks fast, but I don't care if it is fast.
Yeah, man.
I want a car that looks like it's there, but really, it's just normal. It just looks that way. I'll be happy with a bad boy car with a 1.4 engine in it.
Yeah, Ferrari with a 1.8 engine.
Chilling.
On that,
ever steered you wrong, bro?
The bike, we got me on the bikes.
Yeah.
Training, life. Yeah. So you got the car things.
You can't have it all.
So, you know what it is? You're going to have to let me have that one. You've done a good job with me. I'm doing good. Some people say I'm doing all right.
Yeah.
You raise your kids. You hope for the best for them, but fuck, you know. What can you do?
Two. Yep. Three. Yeah, man, perfect now, bro. And again. Yeah, good. Four. Good. Yep. Yeah, good. Come on, don't stand down. Tight. Right. Yeah, good, good. And again. Come on, solid these up. Let's go. Ah, you got one more. Okay. That's it. Better rep. Better. You rushed that one. Here we go. Lovely. Last one. Finish off, 10 reps, tight. Yeah, big luck out, good work, and work all the way.
Lighted, man.
I think the good thing, or where we're trying to be in terms of training, is obviously as intense as possible, but taking your sets to almost failure to the top end of your working set, but without completely burying yourself. So obviously that's a high intense set. Probably had maybe two more reps in, maybe with a bit of broken form or whatnot. But we want to stop just before that point. Obviously, as is coming through prep, we're 6 weeks out, calories are low. You've got to manage fatigue and recovery just as much as you manage how hard you're pushing in the gym. So it's hard to find a balance sometimes, and we speak about it with our clients. But we've got to learn how to give 100% intensity to the right point and then pull back and allow for recovery and not go too much. So that do you get what I'm saying? That makes sense. So that set was perfect.
I feel like this is the wrong song for what you were about to do, man. It's just chilled, everyone's silent.
So I man, we'll use it, we'll tap into it, we'll find the energy. In the morning.
I'm
bollocks. Yep. Good. Yep. Good.
And again.
Come on, yep. Yep. Good.
Boom.
Let's go. Oh. Come on.
Boom.
Yeah, good. And again. Let's go. Yep. Come on, finish it, let's go! Yep!
Yeah, there we are.
And again. Let's go, come on.
One more of these,
let's go.
Fuck it. Oh, come on.
Come on, don't let it be here, let's go!
Yeah,
fuck it, bro.
Good!
One more!
And again.
Oh, man.
Push. Let's go. Last one.
Yeah.
Good.
Well done.
Jubbly.
Go. You going again then, or what? Get the fuck off
the pad, mate! That was way harder than it should have been. But like I was saying, I said it just before the working set. Things were moving slow for me today. So it was a bit of a stop and start set. So some people might not call it a full set, but I wanted to make sure I hit the rep range, which was 12 reps. We got it. I got through it. That's all that matters, still good quality of reps. So I'd much rather take that 5-10 seconds and get a good quality rep rather than not hit my rep range or do shit reps.
You can get like a 15, 14
play
for like
6 grand.
You guys think financially, bro?
I know. Well, I do want a nice car.
Yeah.
I want a newer car, man. I want the...
It's not brand new.
Nah, I don't want brand new. I want the luxury of a newer car. I don't care about the performance.
23 grand for BMW X5 M Sport.
That's more like it.
Have you serviced it yet?
No, what does that mean? Me servicing? I was waiting for you to service it.
I was waiting for you to sort it for me, Dad. Yeah, does my bundle look good?
Yeah, man.
Mine's got gates, you know.
I've always got a big ass.
A big bunder and that. You see big one mum and that, and they turn around and they're like that. What are you doing, bro?
Oh yeah.
So laugh right, but my man has got a flat back. Back, straight no bum, straight down to his foot.
Straight.
It's not good, man. It's not good for your appearance.
Don't trust a man unless you know what I mean?
Can't be,
what do you mean, bro? Where's your battery? Yeah, sort yourself out.
Life lessons with Sedz.
Yeah.
Don't trust a man with no body.
No. You can have that one for free.
Right guys, so currently 5 weeks out. This is our 5 weeks out video. I think the last one that we uploaded on YouTube was 12 weeks out, but we made an executive decision to kind of change things around. For those who are following, currently expecting our first little boy, me and Chelsea. So when he's actually due was kind of in between the show dates, so I didn't want to have to kind of stop the show or anything like that. So made the decision to kind of bring the show a little bit earlier. Now, my advice to anyone doing a first time show or competing out there, doing early shows isn't really, you know, a thing to do. Just because you always want to have time on your hands, you always want to kind of be in control of it. you always want to kind of manipulate and, you know, take advantage of the time that you've got to put yourself in the best possible position to, you know, do the best you can. So fortunately, I'm in a position where I kind of know my body quite well. With business and everything going on, I thought, you know, the best option would be get a show done early and then I can spend time with my family after that. So yeah, 5 weeks till the show, me and Joe, and obviously all of that team have put a plan together. So currently at the moment, I think in the last video we actually spoke about the whole diet setup. We've slightly changed things around now, so I'm trying something different where I'm actually fasting from about my last meal at night, which is around about 9:10 till about 11 o'clock the next day. Something I've never done before, but to be honest, it's probably one of the best diets I've been on. It's pretty straightforward. As we spoke about before, there's no training day or non-training day diet. It's one set diet with 5 meals on, which we'll probably go into a little bit more detail on like a full day of eating, but to pretty much give you guys a rundown, we're 5 weeks out. Current cardio setup is just 10K steps, so there's no direct cardio involved at the moment. Calories have been brought down, or macros have been brought down to around about 1.2 gram of protein per pound of body weight, and also around about 150 carbs. Bearing in mind, I knew myself, I'm around about 2 weeks behind, so it doesn't bother me. If anything, it gives me more motivation to push hard. I know what I gotta do, I know how long I got, we've just gotta dig deep and push through. So me and the whole of the team have put that plan in place, and you know, it's time to get it. So we've got 5 weeks left. Currently, everyone kind of talks about how they're feeling during prep. Not really struggling too bad. Some hunger issues at certain times, but you know, there's no one forcing me to do this. It's my own decision. And to anyone out there, if you're doing a prep, if you feel like you're struggling, just try and enjoy it. You know, think about it, you know, your overall goal. Think about the people you're competing against. At the end of the day, they're not gonna be slipping up. They're not gonna be missing their cardio. They're not gonna be cheating on their diet. When you go on stage, you wanna know in your head that you've done everything possible to make sure you get that first place. Because when you do step on stage, there's nothing more you can do other than enjoy it and showcase what you've been working for. So every session counts, every week counts, every day counts. 5 weeks, let's go.
What are you doing here?
Free bar.
Bye.
Nothing
on there?
What am I supposed to put the bar
training
on?
Training Scots!
God!
Isn't that
listen to me?
Angry Scots.
I don't get angry anymore, guys.
Angry Scots.
I'm passive Scot these days.
I don't get fucking angry anymore!
For those that don't know, Scott used to be the angry skeezer. Yeah,
not anymore though.
He was like a cranky old man when he was younger and he'd grown out of it.
Benjamin Button.
Yeah. Benjamin Button's a drunk.
Yeah, I was an old grumpy man. Now I'm a
old grumpy man.
He goes to expression with being, fuck's sake! Fucking hell!
You know what, I'm not angry, I'm sensitive, man.
Oh.
I'm a sensitive soul.
Oh.
So I'm doing this one. Now you're telling me not to do this one. So what am I doing here? No answer.
Follow instructions. Do you know what just happened? I just said exactly that and no one's listening.
Not this again, Theo. I remember I've done a video like this before.
And someone will say exactly the same now and it will all of a sudden make sense.
Alright, I'm taking control.
Look at me.
Sure.
Look at me.
Sure.
I'm the captain now.
I take control. So, going into arms, 3 movements for biceps, 3 movements for triceps. As we said earlier, this is our top up day. So, arms is something that we're all trying to work on. We're going to go a little bit higher volume. Towards the end of the week, energy's a little bit low, fatigue's kicking in. So, we're trying to keep it moving. So, we're going. Straight bar curls into rope hammer curls into single arm D handle curls, all biceps, 3 rounds, 3 exercises. As soon as we've done that, we go straight out to triceps. Same again, 3 rounds, 3 exercises. But we'll talk you through those as we go through it. My set. Guys, so on to triceps. As I said, we're doing 3 rounds on biceps, 3 exercises, so 9 sets total.
Same thing goes for tries. So this time we're doing two cable movements, one compound. So we're going tricep extensions with the rounded bar, wider grip, elbows flared out a little bit just so we're hitting it from different angles. Then we go rope extensions, nice and strict, flaring out at the bottom, and then straight into a close grip bench press. Same, just so we've got that sort of mass builder. I like to do the compound at the end of the little circuit. Yes, with more fatigue, yes, I can't lift as much, but yeah, I have to work that a little bit harder. And as it's a top up day, as I said earlier, fatigue, you know, is quite high. We're quite spent from the deadlifts as well. Plus, we've got rest day tomorrow and then our push days on Monday. So we're almost like pretty exhausted on those first two movements. Getting whatever I can out of this, decent weight, and three rounds gonna be enough just to get the job done for today. So twice, three rounds, three exercises. Tries, three rounds, three exercises. Not crazy weight, but that's heavy enough. I was right at failure around 12 reps. Jordan spotted me for the last three. Trying to keep my elbows nice and tight. You'll notice on close grip bench, I see a lot of people, especially beginners, going super close and you're almost pressing like that. Just from there, you can see that's not a natural angle. No good for your wrist. You're not really going to be working your triceps. So I like to go a bit more of a neutral grip. I'll go suicide grip as well and just keep these elbows tucked in. Imagine there's Velcro on the side of your ribs there to the inside of your bicep. Everything tucked in, squeezing that tricep at the top. Nice and controlled movements all the way through, all the way through the negative, all the way through the press. Nice big squeeze at the top. So three rounds of this and then we're done for the day.
Scott has never seen this film.
Show me again. It looks like I'm familiar, but...
I'm really disappointed. First of all, you pulled this one with the cars. Now you haven't seen this film. That's your homework for tonight. Go on, watch that.
Yeah.
You'll be a better man tomorrow.
Right. Sorry, lads. I'm sorry I let you down, lads. Like I said, can't do all.
If you haven't
can
seen
do most of it.
If you haven't seen Rodos, you haven't hit you, but you know. Shit, man.
That's why I've got no hair. Down here, not. That's why I had to go to Turkey and get some, because I'm losing it.